So now another new command for all of you. The question is, how do you know what is the column name? See, in this case, select star from hr.employees. Okay, in this case, the column names are few, like we can count how many, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. There are only 11 column names. It's easy to, select the column name that you want and query it. But there are cases inside the database where there are more than 150 columns or sometimes 90 columns, 125 columns. In those cases, how would you know which column to query? And, if you see the output, you will have a scroll bar, then you'll have to move the scroll bar this side to view all the column names. So it's hard. Shouldn't there be a command inside the database that just tells me the structure of the table? Now, this is your next new command after the select statement. Of course, we'll be coming back to the select statement again, but this command is called as describe command. Describe table name. So guys, whenever I say table name, it is always one and the same, owner.table name. That's the exact syntax, but if you don't specify the owner name, it will take the current user as the owner of the table. So owner.table name. So this command will give you the column names, the structure of the table, and the data types. Let us try to check the employee table structure. So how do we check it? You can type the entire command describe hr.employees. Now when you run this command, can you see? Okay, forget about this output. This was output from our earlier command. This is the new output, okay? Now we can see that this name is nothing but your column name. Employee ID is one column, first name is another column, last name, email, phone number, hire date, job ID, salary, commission, manager ID, department ID, right? These all are your column names. And this part will define whether your column can accept null values or not. So we can simply see and say that employee ID can never be null. That means if you try to insert data with no value in the employee ID, the database will reject the record. The first name can be null, but the last name, it cannot be null. We need to have some value in the last name, otherwise the record will be rejected. Same goes with email, same goes with hire date and job ID. Rest all columns can be null. Now this all depends on how the database is designed, how the tables are designed when the database architect works with the client. And this is the type of the column. That means what type of data is stored inside the columns. Employee ID in this case is a number with the size of 6 digits. That's the total size of the employee ID. And then first name, varchar2. So don't worry about these varchar or char data types for now. This is nothing but the character data type for your understanding, but later on we will be working on data types separately. So this column will accept numbers. This column will accept all these columns where you see varchar. It will only accept the character data type. Hire date will accept the date data type. Again, job ID is nothing but it's a character data type column. Salary is a number which is of 8-digit salary, and then out of these 8 digits, 2 digits will be after the point. So it's something like this. So 6 digits, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 0, 7, 8. This is a valid value in this column. So 2 digits will always be after the decimal point. Commission, again the same thing. And manager ID number 6 and department is number 4, right? So this command, guys, describe command, there is another short form of this command, DESC, and again owner dot table underscore name. Whether you type entire command describe or DESC, it's one and the same. So let us try to check DESC HR dot jobs. This is another table inside the HR schema. Now can you see the name? These are the column names, job ID, job title, minimum salary, max salary. These two columns will accept the character data type and these two columns will accept the number data type. And two columns can never accept null value. So if you insert nothing in those columns, then your insert will be rejected. It will actually throw an error for the insert.